Sorry about that, guys. My video cut off, so we're just gonna start all over again, okay? We're gonna be doing a love reading for Virgos dealing with a Leo, Sagittarius, Aries here. I pulled the first cards out of my Mystic Black Rose deck. First card that came out was coffee, date, meeting up, planning, discussing, multiple... dating multiple people, excuse me. Forbidden fruit, non-committal, sexual entity, tragedy with lust here. Pain, guarded, apprehensive, putting up a wall, excruciating pain. Finality, difference, divorce, breakup, not looking back. Independent, freedom from attachments, available to date here. This is the energy I'm getting with Virgos dealing with an Aries, Leo, Sagittarius, fire sign here. Okay, at the bottom, roller coaster ride, ups and downs, good and bad, rush of feelings. So Virgo, from this energy here, I'm really getting that you are in a roller coaster relationship with a fire sign, right? You guys may be separated at this point. You may have put a final decision to divorce, break up with this person. You're not looking back here. Virgos, there may be still some mixing of the energy because I see that you two are meeting up here. And with the lust, obviously, you have to be meeting up and seeing each other to have this lust for each other. But I feel like it's all about lust now. Like, there's no love left in this situation. Or maybe there is, but it's too painful to love each other. It's easier to meet up and be lustful. You feel me? Let's really dive deep into this. What can you tell Virgos about coffee date, meeting up, planning, discussing, dating multiple people here? For Virgos dealing with a fire sign, we got playfulness. To recapture romance, allow your inner youthful spirit to spirit of fun to shine. Okay, so I feel like Virgos, this is really symbolizing you or this person trying to recapture romance in their life after a terrible breakup. You feel me? Or you guys could just be, when you meet up, when you're discussing, when you're planning, you're trying to be more youthful and fun instead of toxic and lustful. You feel me? What is going on for the lust here with Virgos dealing with Aries, Leo, Sagittarius? With the honeymoon here, enjoy the holiday bliss time together. Okay, so from that energy, I feel like you guys have definitely time spent with each other. Maybe you're in a situation where you're co-parenting, or maybe you're in a situation where you just still spend time with this person, but it's only temporary, with the honeymoon phase type of thing. There's this temporary time where you guys spend with each other, and you guys go from toxicity to lust here, okay? With the enjoying each other and forbidden fruit. I feel like you guys are allowing each other to enjoy each other in this phase, in this period, while you guys break up, because you know after this, there's no commitment, you know? There's no... There's an end to this, is the point. What do you have to tell Virgos about the pain here? Guarded, apprehensive. Wedding. This situation involves a wedding. Okay, so Virgos, you are very... This hurts you. This situation with a Leo, Sagittarius, Aries hurt you deeply because this was a marriage. This was a long-term relationship here. You guys could have had kids together. You guys could have had a whole life plan together. And now you are really guarded with your with yourself because of the pain this situation caused you here. Okay, what if we tell Virgos with a fatality? Differences, divorce, breakup, not looking back. Finality. Healing family issues. Your love life benefits as you heal, as you forgive your parents. Okay, so I feel like, Virgo, the reason you're not looking back on this situation, the reason you're breaking up, the reason you have divorces is basic family issues. Like, the dynamic of the family structure was unhealthy, was toxic. It just needed to end here. There was a lot of issues in the family that needed healing, and I guess you guys couldn't work that out together. What's going on with the single, independent, freedom from attachment? For Virgos dealing with Leo, Sagittarius, Aries. Forgiving and learning. As you release and heal the past, you're experiencing more love in your present moments here, okay? Virgos, spirit is straight up telling you this looks like a plan, like a master plan to get you out of a terrible situation here, okay? I feel like, Virgos, there had to be some extreme pain in a wedding, in a marriage. There had to be something extremely painful to really get you to end and break up with this person. I feel like there may have been something that orchestrated that. There may have been something that played into this being ended for you to put you in a situation where you heal and learn from your family issues, grow in these generational curses, grow from these generational curses, learn and forgive and heal yourself in a single independent freedom state. And I love that energy, Virgo. I love it. Okay. Let's get into the oracles. Let's get into some oracle messages here. From my Globe deck, let's see what the tea was in the situation. What's the tea about Virgo with this coffee and dating and playfulness? What's the tea about Virgo dating? Okay, Virgo, the thing about you dating, okay, you meeting up and planning and discussing dating multiple people, the tea about this is there is a Gemini here waiting to reconcile, okay? This person is waiting to meet up. This person may be planning, discussing this, and this person may be also dating multiple people, but they want to recapture moments with you. They came out immediately, honey. So if you're getting back out there, you're ready to date, there may be Gemini ready to reconciliate, okay? What's going on for the honeymoon and lust here for the Virgos? Honeymoon, lust, non-forbidden, forbidden fruit, non-committal, sexual energy, tragedy. What's this honeymoon lust going on for Virgos dealing with? Oh, shit. Karma here at the bottom. With the honeymoon and lust, non-committal, sexual energy, Virgos, I feel like the reason you are only enjoying this phase of honeymoon or only enjoying this person in phases is because there's some third party here. I feel like there was a, like I said, there was something that illustrated, that orchestrated you breaking up from this person, like I said a few minutes ago, and I feel like it was something around this third party. So I feel like now with this person, lust is forbidden. Now with this person, lust is non-committal energy with this person. So once this third party came in, you only allowed yourself to enjoy phases of lust with this person, I feel, because there is some type of third party energy here interfering. We'll get in more into that, y'all. Mm-hmm. What's going on here with the wedding? Apprehensive, putting up walls, excruciating pain. Pain in a marriage here for the Virgos. Yeah. Okay, the pain in the marriage here with the Virgos, with the Leo, Sagittarius, Aries here, was this person was a narcissist. This person was controlling. This person was a cheater. This person was abusive, okay? They are the ones who caused all the pain in this relationship. I feel like after a long time of feeling pain in the relationship, the third party was like a cherry on top. It's like the only thing to make Virgo move. Because once Virgo loves you, honey, once a Virgo loves you, that earth energy gets real comfortable in their domain and they love you here. It takes a lot for a Virgo to walk away. But when he does, you're not getting that Virgo back, okay? Single and independent here. Learn the lessons from this shit here, okay? You ain't getting that Virgo back. Anyways, healing family issues, finality differences, breakup, not looking back here. I'm telling you, not looking back. There's no way. After Virgo heals from this pain, look, you tell Virgos, child, look at, what did I say? There's no way. Big N-O came out, okay? There's no way you are getting this Virgo back after the situation, okay? Virgo is deciding to use their will to say no here. They don't want to get burned by this person anymore, this Leo, Sagittarius, Aries. They're hitting them with the twos here and healing themselves, healing their self-esteem, healing their minds, healing their family dynamic, their family curses that let them go down this path anyways, okay? I'm feeling like Virgos are really, really trying to get on their shit 2022 here to be single and independent and learn how to rise from this situation, okay? Forgiving and learning. I love that energy, by the way. Keep it moving. Forgiving and learning for the Virgos. Right. Honey, forgiving and learning and being independent, free from attachments, available to date. Virgo, I feel like that's just a detour for you, honey. I feel like that Oh, baby, I feel like you being single and learning for learning from your mistakes here is to release these blockages, honey. It's to get you to wait up to heal yourself. This is just a detour because it's not the right time to have what you're supposed to have at this time. Spirit is putting you in this energy to be single just because you've never been, or just because you need to be, or just because you need to learn that independence, or just because you need to be in a state, in a single state to get your blessings here. Let's ask one more time. Okay, after Virgo gets out of this detour, this single independent detour phase, what do we have to tell our Virgos after they learn, heal, forgive? What's coming in for our Virgos after this blockage here? After they learn how to be single and independent, fruitful. Let's see. I'm excited because new start came out, Virgo. After you learn how to do for yourself, I see this beautiful new start here. First off. Oh my goodness. And then we have cut the cord in spiritual jail, Virgo. I don't know if I can illustrate how profound this is, Virgo, but your spirit guides and ancestors are telling you that you learning from yourself, learning from your mistakes, being single here is just a detour to what, honey? Cut the cords to soul draining attachments, to literally get you out of bondage, this mental physical jail that this karmic situation put on you. You will literally be released from the karmic. You have learned everything you needed to learn in the situation. You have gained your freedom from karmic jail, is what it's saying here, from karmic soul ties. That's what will happen after this independent stage, Virgo. This literally, I can't make it up. This mental spiritual jail that you placed yourself into. Okay, or maybe that spirit placed you into to learn from something, to make you learn, to make you see, to put you in a state to have this new beginning, free from any soul ties, free from any karmic energy there. Okay, I'm loving this small fucking energy. Oh my gosh, y'all. Oh my gosh, I'm loving it. This got me hype. What can we tell our Virgos here? First off, let's pull something on this Gemini here, because this person was just off the bat. You said you dating and you single, Virgo? Off the bat, Gemini pop out talking about he want to reconcile. What's this about for the Virgos? Keys on a ring, many options discussing, unconventional string along one night stand. Okay, this Gemini who wants to reconcile, this person could have led you on, strung you along a little in the beginning at first. This person could have had many options, dating multiple people down there on that card, many options on this card. This person probably had a lot of options. They had a lot of decisions to make and they didn't make the right one. But now they want to reconcile. Okay, that's what they can tell you about this Gemini here. What can we tell the Virgos about the Gemini who wants to reconcile? The Chaser. Oh my God. Chaser in a codependent relationship, fear of abandonment issues. So, Virgo, this Gemini is now a chaser in this situation. They see that you are free and single. Look. Free and single, and now they want to chase here. But the snake came out. Okay, competition, enemy, clever, malicious, look over your shoulder, the other woman. Third party situation right next to it. So Virgo, I feel like this is the energy for you. Okay, you got a lot of people around with it's just drama, child. Entanglement and drama. Okay, there's this chaser may be a snake to this Gemini, or this Gemini could be chasing you. Take it as it resonates. But this Gemini definitely has a snake in the energy, baby. The runner, the runner and the chaser, and then the snake in the middle. I can't make this up. This Gemini here who wants to reconcile is in a toxic dynamic where they are running away from a snake here who is chasing them, who is one of their love options. Okay, so take that as it resonates here. Twin flame. Okay, this Gemini feels like, or this could be a twin flame to you, honey. But they're still presently in the energy of having some type of dirty dynamic there that you don't want to be involved in, honey. Because you are making what healthy choices in your life, making healthy choices, in love and life, self-love, self-care, being happy. That's what you're doing. So if you want to be tangled up with all that mess, go for a child. But I don't recommend it. I feel like you need to stay single on your grind and keep moving forward to end this spiritual bondage. Okay. Let's move on here. Let's do honeymoon lust third party. Let's pull some tarot on the situation. What is this honeymoon lust third party energy for the Virgos here? We gonna find out, baby, because what's this third party energy for the Virgos dealing with Leo, Sagittarius, Aries? Third party energy for Virgos dealing with Leo, Sagittarius, Aries here. Okay, let's see what that's all about. King of Cups. So Virgo, this Leo Sagittarius Aries here is showing up as a King of Cups here. I'm going to lead it a couple ways, okay? They're showing up as a King of Cups here. This King of Cups love you, but they're holding back their love because they're all up in their head in a mental prison here with the Nine of Swords. Fear and anxiety around this situation. Four of Cups, I feel like because you've withdrawn from the situation. You have been aloof. You've detached this person. It's putting them in their heads, but they still love you. What's this third party energy about? For Virgo is dealing with Leo, Sagittarius, Aries. Okay, I see this person holding on and I see judgment coming out. So maybe they did something to cause some type of judgment in their life, to have some type of karma in their life here. Or maybe that's just symbolizing them wanting to reconcile. Let's see. What is this third party energy for Virgo is dealing with Leo, Sagittarius, Aries here? The Moon. We got the Hierophant in the reverse, the Eight of Cups in the reverse, and the Moon. Okay, so with the Hierophant in the reverse energy, I feel like this was I feel like the values in this relationship weren't allowing with each other. Maybe you guys didn't have the same traditional values. With the Eight of Cups in the reverse, it's almost like the energy of stepping out of a marriage here. Okay, with the third party energy, that's why I'm saying it. That's here, but I'm not getting that in the tarot. We'll keep going. But so far, I'm not getting it in the tarot. It's just here. It's just giving me the energy of values not aligning in the marriage. And somebody may have stepped out here or wanting to return. Okay, maybe the marriage turned upside down because there was a thought or an inclination of a third party, but somebody here doesn't want to walk away from the situation, but there's still something here that's hidden with the Moon. Okay, so let's see here. What's hidden with the Moon? Can you tell me about this third party energy in the Moon? We got the Queen of Wands, okay? Queen of Wands often is like third party energy, karmic energy for me. Queen of Wands, the Two of Wands, the Princess of Wands, and Justice. What was hidden? What's the third party energy? There was definitely a Queen of Wands in the situation. Okay, who is this Queen of Wands? It's almost like this person planned something. Yeah, the Eight of Pentacles and the High Priestess. Like, you had a higher knowing that this person was planning or plotting to do something with the Queen of Wands here, with the Princess of Wands here. That can indicate, like, free spirit, free-moving person doing whatever, and then the Justice right after that. It's almost like it was an unjust situation, or that you will get justice for this situation, or that you had a higher knowing that this person was working with somebody behind your back, okay? I feel like there would be justice in this situation. Could be a Libra, Leo, Sagittarius, Aries. This could be just their energy coming up as a Queen of Wands who was plotting to be a free spirit. They were maybe working towards being in a third party. I don't know, y'all. I'm not getting real third party energy. So this could just be like literal outside influences here. Then we have the Queen of Wands, the Queen of Swords there that wanted to come out. And then we have the Three of Pentacles, Ten of Pentacles, Four of Wands in the reverse. Yeah, y'all. Okay, then we have the Empress. Okay, so a lot of queens did pop up. So there could have been some type of third party energy. I don't feel the need to go in deeper in that at all. Okay, there was just some type of third party interference here with the cheater, liar, abusive, narcissist. I don't think we need to get in that either. I think we need to get into, what does Virgo need to use their will to say no to with a Leo, Sagittarius, Aries? Princess of Cups and the Ace of Swords. So Virgo, even if this person comes in with an apology, clarity, honesty, truth, you still need to say no to this person. Spirit is telling you. Yeah, with the Three of Cups and the Five of Swords, Spirit is telling you to fight reconciling with this person. There would be conflict, competition. There would just be chaos if you reconcile with this person, had a reunion with this person. What does Virgo need to say no to? Okay, use your will, say no, and walk away from this person. Leo, Sagittarius, Aries. That's what you need to do. What can we tell Virgo about this new start here? Forgiving and learning, being independent and single. What can we tell Virgo? Seven of Wands. Yeah, you definitely have to set boundaries with a soul tie, with a karmic here to get out of this jail situation. Set boundaries, move on, and elevate your life, honey. What can we tell Virgo? Yeah, this, we're going to be having a new start here with the Fool. Again, new start, new start. Spirit is really telling you that you need rest. You need to focus on healing and resting yourself. You need to have radical focus on yourself, self-care, healing, resting. Okay, fixing mental issues that you may have gotten from this situation. And with the Moon in the reverse, I feel like that is really symbolizing you coming up out of being hidden, right? And there's also a lot of fears and paranoias regarding you being on your own that you need to focus on and heal from, right? And then we have the Tower, okay? The Knight of Pentacles and the Tower. I feel like this is, you investing in yourself is going to bring some type of tower for other people. Or it might bring a mini tower for you. Towers don't always have to be bad, honey. The Two of Pentacles and the Queen of Swords. Towers don't always have to be bad. That could just be a new foundation, okay? Princess of Pentacles. One more for the Virgos in this new start. The King of Wands, okay? Telling the same story over and over again here. The Queen of Wands. You need to invest in yourself. That's definitely going to cause a tower for a karmic here. I'm guessing this King of Wands here, Leo, Sagittarius, Aries. It's literally saying finding your balance, learning from and gaining knowledge and standing on that knowledge, cutting everything out that needs to be cut out. Divorce card, you feel me? Standing on your truth here and not investing with this King of Wands here. This is the only investment you can have with the King of Wands, is a detached, divorced investment. So maybe co-parenting, honey, maybe teamwork, but Spirit wants you to always be closed off, cold, disconnected from this Leo, Sagittarius, Aries to gain and control your freedom. Ashe. That's what I have for the Virgos here. If you like or resonated with anything here in my video, please give me a like, comment down below. Subscribe to the channel to see what's coming up next for the Virgos. And you know, thank you for watching.